Hello guys, how are you? Welcome to Webstar Press. If you are new here, consider subscribing to the channel. cPanel based web hostings allow users to install Let's Encrypt free SSL for their domains. Let's Encrypt is a free SSL certificate that secures your websites and encrypts all communication between front-end and web server. SSL is very important for every website. If you don't have an SSL, web browsers mark the website as not secure. Free SSL is offered by every web host out there, and if you have got your own web server, you can install free SSL by Let's Encrypt for your websites with ease. Web hosts provide a mechanism for its auto-renewal process by default. So for web browsers, it makes sense to mark the website without SSL as not secure because it's so easy and free to get it. When you get web hosting, SSL is not installed at it by default. You have to install it. You can do that easily by going to SSL certificate area from your cPanel. Look for SSL TLS status from your cPanel to check SSL status and to run AutoSSL for your websites. During AutoSSL run, you may encounter this issue. You will get an error message like an error occurred the last time AutoSSL ran. We are going to answer this error in our video. This is our cPanel. To enable SSL certificate or to check its status, you will look for the area security in cPanel. Under security, find option that says SSL TLS status. Click at that option to open SSL option interface for your domains. At SSL TLS interface, your domains and subdomains will be listed there. Let me mention that you need separate SSL for each domain and subdomain. In case of Let's Encrypt, there are single domain SSL certificates, multiple domains SSL certificates, and wildcard SSL certificates. Let's Encrypt is a single domain based SSL certificate. It's not wildcard or multiple domain SSL. Okay, see run AutoSSL button with green arrow. In my case, AutoSSL ran, but it encountered error. So action could not be completed. SSL was not installed on my domains and subdomains. We can select all domains and subdomains and run AutoSSL for all of them. So as you can see, SSL could not be installed, and the error message details say that web server misconfiguration may exist. Here I have selected all domains and subdomains and ran AutoSSL again. The button status says that AutoSSL is in progress. And the same error encountered again. So I came to the cPanel and opened up my file manager to see what's going on with web server configuration. Maybe there is something wrong with the htaccess file. Htaccess file can be used to run commands for server, and playing with the htaccess commands is my favorite hobby. So here is the file manager, and you can see the .htaccess file. If you cannot see the .htaccess file, it means that it's hidden, and you can make it visible by changing file manager settings and selecting show hidden files. So I selected edit .htaccess file to open it in editor. And here you can see all the madness going on. I have some rewrite conditions, rules, and .htaccess is denied by all. I have disallowed access to all hidden files and redirect is set to error 403. I have got Commodore DCV in my HDXS, whereas I am interested in installing Let's Encrypt SSL certificate. There's a lot more inside HDXS file, so where can be the issue? Let's remove rewrite conditions with Commodore DCV entry. Here I removed rewrite conditions and saved HDXS file. The rewrite conditions may also come from cPanel redirect area settings. Make sure you have not applied crazy rules in redirection area of cPanel. And now I came back to the AutoSSL area again and clicked Run AutoSSL again. Encountered error again, but this time error message changed. Error 403. That means forbidden, and our old error about web server misconfiguration is also present there. I came back to the HDXS file and I noticed that I had disallowed all hidden files with error redirect 403. Error 403 means forbidden. So let's remove it. Here I removed that rule that said disallow all hidden files. I came back to SSL certificate area and hit Run AutoSSL. As you can see, this time it went through. AutoSSL has installed Let's Encrypt on all my domains successfully. The green log is confirming that. Let's visit redirects area in cPanel. That area can be point of pain sometimes. Here you can see the redirects that are in place. You can see the redirects. If you apply redirects here, your HDXS file will be updated with rules. If you remove rules directly from HDXS file, those rules mentioned in this redirects area will be deleted. So there is a relation between redirects area and .htaccess file. So apply those rules that are not strict, or if you want to keep those strict rules, disable those while installing SSL or while running AutoSSL and enable again when you are done. Usually system files are hidden files. If you disallow hidden files for all sources, your server may also find it hard to access and modify those files. So while performing such actions, you want to make sure you have proper permissions on files and system, and you are not blocking system access to your config files. So disable restrictions and run AutoSSL. It will be installed successfully on domains. I hope this video has helped you in this regard. That's it guys, I hope you liked this video. If I missed anything or you have something to add, you can comment down below. Ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media, links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.